can't believe another week has flown by. I hope you were able to find a song in your heart this week that put a spring in your step, in spite of the ongoing effects that this pandemic is having on each of us. And speaking of finding a song in your heart, I am afraid that last week I misquoted the words of the Waymaker chorus. I shared that the chorus was Waymaker, Beautiful Savior, Promise Keeper, Light of the World, when in actuality, it is Waymaker, Miracle Worker, Promise Keeper, Light in the Darkness. Well, while the syllables worked, I was not quite accurate, although God is all of those things and more. So, you know, one of my biggest fears in presenting these videos is unintentionally not being completely correct in what I share. So I wanted to make sure I clarified and that I corrected that mistake. Sharing that fear with you leads me to what I wanted to discuss today. Fear. Fear is a primary emotion that serves as the foundation for many other secondary emotions, such as confusion, helplessness, anxiety, insecurity, bewilderment, worry, or discouragement. During this pandemic, I'm sure each of us have experienced and wrestled with at least one or more of those feelings. And recognizing we have those feelings is a good thing, but giving in to those feelings is not what God would want us to do. He wants us to fight fear with faith in who He is, being confident that He is in control of all things. We strengthen our faith through scripture reading and prayer. Some Bible teachers have said that there are 366 fear not verses in the Bible, one for each day of the year plus leap year, like 2020. In actuality, that's not true. The King James Version of the Bible only has 103 fear not verses in it, which is the most repeated command in the Bible. But you know, it doesn't really matter how many times the Bible says it, whether 5 or 500 times. The fact is that the Bible says, do not fear. When Jesus preached his famous Sermon on the Mount, he taught the crowds that when it came to food and clothing, do not worry. I'm taking care of you. Just keep putting me first, and I promise I will take care of the rest. A few chapters later, in Matthew 10, as Jesus is sending out the disciples to preach, he says, don't be afraid of those who can kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. Rather, be afraid of the one who can destroy both the body and soul. What Jesus was saying there is that our fear should be that we would give in to the lies and defeat of our enemy Satan, who seeks to destroy us. That is who we need to fear. Fear, like every other emotion, informs us how we are doing mentally, emotionally, physically, socially, and spiritually. Fear is not necessarily a bad emotion either. It can alert us when we are in danger, or it can let us know when we need to quickly change our behavior. But fear can be debilitating if not acknowledged and dealt with. And as mentioned before, prayer and scripture are great antidotes in dealing with fear. In addition to prayer and scripture reading, I would like to offer 4 tips based on the acronym FEAR that are helpful in keeping fear in check and its accompanying negative emotions. First of all, F, fight fatigue. At this point in the pandemic, we are all weary of the circumstances we find ourselves in, whether it be physically, emotionally, or mentally. We are tired of hearing bad news. We are tired of the threat of getting sick or worrying about finances. And a feeding ground for fear that grips us more tightly is when we are physically tired. To counter fatigue, it is important to have a good sleep routine in place, both for you and for those in your household. Make sure that those routines include getting enough sleep. The optimal amount of sleep for adults is 7.5 to 8 hours of sleep a night. For teens, it is 8 to 10 hours a night. And for children, it is 10 to 11 hours a night. In a stressful time, such as what we are experiencing right now, having enough rest is essential to maintaining our mental and emotional outlook and keeping negative emotions in check. Sometimes, the most spiritual thing we can do is take a nap. John Ortberg says it well when he says, "Sometimes you just need to eat a snack and take a nap." Which leads us to the next letter. F is for fight fatigue. E is for eat right and exercise. I remember as a young driver putting gas in my parents' car one day, thinking I was being responsible and filling up the tank with my hard-earned check from Taco Bell. Unfortunately, I put the wrong kind of gas in the car. And guess what? It didn't run very well. In fact, it made a terrible knocking noise. What I thought would make the car run actually hurt it. And you know, the same principle applies to the food we put in our bodies, our fuel. Our bodies are intended to function on the most natural of foods, lean meats, poultry, fish, vegetables, fruits, and whole grains. In our society, however, we have become accustomed to the convenience of processed foods, which offers far less quality nutrient-wise. As well, the quantity and variety of food that is available to us makes it very easy to overeat. Eating right and participating daily in some sort of exercise where we breathe deeply and get our heart rate up can help us maintain a healthy attitude in fighting negative emotions. So F is for fight fatigue. E is for eat right and exercise. A is for avoid negative thinking. God has given us the ability to choose what we think about. He has also given us clear direction in Scripture on what those choices should be. He says in Philippians 4:8, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. When we choose to discipline our thoughts and focus on good and not evil, it affects our outlook and puts the focus on God and not on our circumstances. Disciplining our thoughts is a surefire way to help keep our fear in check, and it feeds our faith. So, F is for fight fatigue, E is for eat right and exercise, A is for avoid negative thinking, and finally, R, reach out. If you find yourself being consumed by fear, anxiety, worry, or any other negative emotion, please, please reach out to a trusted friend, family member, or trusted counselor and share with them what you're feeling. You have nothing to be ashamed of for what you feel, and there is a reason why you are feeling what you're feeling. Let others who love and care for you help you to identify and get to the root of why you are feeling the way that you are. This is why Cornerstone has established the Biblical Counseling Ministry. There are dear people who are preparing to come beside you, listen, and walk with you in the midst of any fears you might be experiencing. Please contact me at Debbie@cornerstoneyc.com if you would like to speak to someone. Also, there is a local crisis counseling hotline that you can call at 530-674-8650. A local pastor is available 24/7 to listen, talk, and pray with you. Please, whatever you do, don't try to deal with your negative emotions on your own. God designed us that we should bear with one another in times of trouble, and there are people who truly care and desire to help you. These four steps, fight fatigue, eat right and exercise, avoid negative thinking, and reach out to others, are all practical steps that can be implemented starting today, along with prayer and scripture reading. I encourage you, just choose one and get started in your fight against fear. In closing, I want to remind you that there is another definition of fear, and that is a reverential awe or a wonder for God, fearing the Lord. When gripping fear due to circumstances tries to bring you down, I want to encourage you to fight your circumstantial fear with the reverential fear of God and remind yourself that God is faithful. He will never leave you or forsake you. He is Emmanuel. God is with us. He is our authority. And he is over all things and works all things for good. He is our Redeemer. And because of his love for us that he demonstrated on the cross, we have nothing to fear. This week, let's join together and meditate on David's beautiful acknowledgement of Psalm 27, 1 and 2. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? Because God is for us, we can control the fear that we experience. See you next week with another word from Cornerstone Counseling.